happy, gloomy, rainy Saturday, everyone. Good to see you. Welcome to Weekend Wild Card. I'm Jen. Hi, Myung. Good to see everybody today. Man, it is raining outside and it's been non-stop. So this is probably where we would find ourselves on any old regular Saturday. Today is the wild card. And I was like, man, we've been in quarantine for a while. And for a lot of us, like, hoodies and sweats are the norm now. And that's just fine. Hey, Katie. Hey, Gwen. But I was just thinking, you know what? We should add a little pizzazz in our lives. And I know a lot of you are like, yes, let's do some more dance things. So I definitely wanted to incorporate that. And that was the inspiration for today's beginning and end. So today we are doing a yoga sandwich, and that sounds very weird, as you have come to expect from me. But for basically the very beginning warm up, we are doing just one song, one dance. The moves are not incredibly difficult, but it is a little bit like WTF when you first see it. You're like, what is going on? But we'll do it one time in the beginning and one time at the end. And the moves themselves, again, are not very difficult, but I just figured we'd do something and feel just as good in our sweatpants as we do wearing those normal clothes and everything. So that we are used to when we went out and did normal weekend evening things. So on that note, it is 5:30 and I am gonna get us started. So here comes the music. All right. Take a deep breath in. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. It starts off slow. Exhale. It's about posing. Take your time. Some attitude. I work out. almost over, guys. How'd you guys do? The ridiculousness is real, and we are gonna get started with yoga next. So, catch your breath, take off all the outfits. I am very hot now, and we will do that one more time at the end. So, the movements again are not super, super difficult, just designed to get us warmed up a little bit and feel very sexy and know that you're sexy, even in your sweatpants. Okay, on that note, we are taking a totally different vibe, turn, shift, all that stuff. And we will start into some yoga. And now that we know, by the way, that this little dance that we're gonna do once again at the very end is very much about attitude and just posing, really let that shine and get your cameras ready, and we will totally do it all over again at the very, very end. My memory was definitely failing me, so there are moments of like, but we'll see what happens at the very end too. Okay, so we've caught our breath, maybe. We'll move into some yoga. A lot of people mentioned that balance is something that they'd like to work on. So I am all about balance. I really think that is something that's, of course, we can build physically, but it's also something that we can build very much mentally as well. So that's really a wonderful balancing act. If you feel like you're not super, super like strong, like in your legs or in your core, there's so much mental that goes into it. And if you're super strong physically and you're feeling like a little bit wobbly, we can definitely train our minds to just help us stay strong on one leg and in many different positions. So let's go ahead and get started here. Something that seems very, very basic, which is just a tabletop. So your hands underneath your shoulders, your knees underneath your hips. And we're not doing any cat-cows or anything crazy. Just extend your left arm forward and your right leg back. So left arm forward, right leg back, and hold it right there. And from this place, already push your chest away and make sure we're not dumping. So you find very good core strength right in this place. And then from here, changing nothing but your bottom foot. So your left foot, pick your left foot up off of the floor. So now you have only your left knee hitting the floor from the waist down. Hold right there for four. Push your chest away for three. Fight for it here for two, for one. And then lower your left hand down. Send your left toes out to the left. Send your right arm up high toward the ceiling. So your left foot kickstands back behind you. Flex your right foot hard, right? Toes come back toward the skin of your shin. And then bend your right leg, grab a hold of your right foot with your right hand, and kick away. Open your chest, send your right hip forward, your right knee back, and allow that kick to open up your chest, your shoulders, create some space, separate your heel away from your butt. One more breath, kick, and stay for your exhale. Good, from this place without slingshotting, gently let go, return to that place, hold, and maybe you start to look up toward your right fingers, find your balance here, and then we'll try again that bottom foot, your left foot, instead of hitting the floor, we'll lift it up off of the floor. So you can decide where you want to look. And then start to pick your left foot up off of the floor and see how your balance feels. If it's your very first time kind of playing around, experimenting with this, it might feel a little bit tricky. If this feels actually kind of okay to you, start to move your eyes also up toward your right fingers. Continue to lift up out of your left-hand side and really have confidence that you know what this pose feels like. And you just stay one more breath in And one more breath out. Really nice. Lower your left foot down, lower your right hand, right knee back down to the floor. Okay, let's switch the sides. Kind of very random, but extend your right arm forward, your left leg back, and we hold. So long extension from your fingertips all the way back toward your left heel. And again, once you decide mentally you're ready for it, start to pick up your right foot, that bottom foot, up off of the floor, right? For me, pointing these toes is helpful while I'm wobbling about, of course. But send some energy out through both your fingers, your toes, and for my left leg, my heel. Hold one more breath, push. And very nice, lower your right hand down and kickstand your right foot out to the right. Lift your left arm up high toward this ceiling. Hold. Good. From this place, again, get strong, firm through your right arm side. Lift. And then maybe you look up toward your left fingers and stay very light here, your left leg not dropping down below your hip height. So keep it nice and strong. Lift. And then bend your left leg, grab a hold of your left foot. And think of your left arm as really not doing much but holding onto your left foot. So when you kick, your left arm naturally straightens and you start to open up through your chest, your shoulders. Kick your foot into your hand and allow your left hip to come forward, your left knee to draw back. Maybe you even look past your left shoulder. And then from this place, return, find that place, hold. And then again, think of being strong through your right arm, trust in that. Pick up your right toes off of the floor, right? Right toes off of the floor. Before you move on to anything else, right? So I'm still working on my balance here. I'm a little wobbly. But once I feel fairly like confident and strong in this place with my right foot off of the floor, then maybe start to shift your eyes over toward your left fingers as well. And the moment it starts to move, I like just to move my eye gaze again back to one point of focus. And then maybe you don't even look up toward your left fingers today, and that's just fine. Hold one more breath in. I'm a little bit wobbly on this side. And one breath out. Good. Lower your right foot down and then lower your left hand, left knee back to the floor. Good. And then keeping your tops of your feet flat against the floor, right? So we're rather than tucking, we're just going to keep the tops of our feet flat. Use your strong core, strong chest. Just push, lift your knees an inch, hover up off of the floor, and we hold. So there's just that little bit of space underneath your knees. Continue to push your chest away. Now, somebody mentioned yesterday that her triceps and her shoulders felt really, really sore from all those planks that we were doing. And I had to say, me too. Planks are hard, man. And the more we kind of work it, maybe we feel a little bit more efficient in it. But still, it's a lot of work. So not to worry if you're in that boat too and you feel a whole bunch of things happening in your triceps and shoulders. That's exactly what you want to feel, and that's perfect. Good. Lower your knees back down to the floor. Close the distance between your knees, knees together, and sit down, hips on heels. Good. From this place, shift your body weight a little bit more to your right, and then send your left leg out in front of you. Flex your left foot. So your left toes come back toward your face, and you're just sitting hip on heel. Breathe. Chest up nice and tall. Use your fingers on either side to support you. And then from here, lift your left leg off of the floor and lower down. Do it again. Chest up tall. Go. Lift your left leg off the floor and lower down. Twice more. Let's go. Lift your left leg up off of the floor and lower down. Lift your left leg up off of the floor and then hug it in so your left toes come down in line with your right knee. Hands into the center of your chest. Start to stand up. Still the top of your right foot flat against the floor. Good. I'll show you from this angle and then lower back down low. So your right knee lands sort of just in line with your left toes. Let's do it a few more times. Stand up nice and tall, go lift. Top of your right foot gets a lot of love here. And lower back down. Twice more, go lift. And lower down. It's very tempting to separate the distance wider in this position, but try to just hang on to it. One more time, go lift. And then we'll stand from here, pick your right toes up off of the floor, and simply tick-tock yourself, hinge forward, hips square. And then once you're in that place, hold. Keeping your right leg at this height, I want you to gently, gently swing your right leg out to your right, still those pointed toes. Yes, and then take it back behind. Now your shoulders and your chest will want to do all sorts of things. Try to maintain best you can the same place. And then your right leg out to the right. Really think, stick your butt out and take it back. And then two more times here, out to the right. Just getting a little bit warmer. And take it back. I can't really tell if I'm sweating from the dance or just all of this that we're doing right now. And out to the right, out. And take it back. Really nice. From here, single-legged Tadasana. As you come through center, flex your foot, lift. And just step your right foot in front of your left foot. So like you're walking on a tightrope, hold. All right, one foot in front of the other is perfect. Close down your eyes. Take one more breath here in through your nose. And out through your nose. Release your arms down. Keep your eyes closed. Inhale. Lift your arms up high toward the ceiling. Lift. And on your exhale, cactus out your arms. Lift your chest up. And maybe you shift your eyes up. Still your eyes closed though. So if your eyes were open, you'd be looking up toward the ceiling, goalpost. Inhale, lengthen out through your spine. Return your head to neutral. And one more time only, exhale, cactus backward. And still with your eyes closed, but if your eyes were open, you'd be looking up toward the ceiling. Inhale, return arms up. Eyes looking forward, but eyes closed. And hands into heart center, hold. Good. And then from this place, open your eyes. Send your left foot even more to the right. So back behind your left or right leg still, but out to your right hand side. Take your arms all the way up and then go side body stretch out toward your right hand side as you grab a hold of your left wrist. So left leg behind right. Side body stretch out toward your right hand side. And gently return, hands to heart. Slowly sit yourself down for four. Your feet in this place still. For three, let your heels gently lift up off of the floor. For two, see what you can do. For one, lift your legs up, hold. So your right ankle is crossed over your left ankle. You're in a boat position. Good, from this place, take your arms into goalpost, hold. Send your left arm inside of your both legs, twist to your right, hold. Good, unhook, come back through center, switch out your ankles. Right arm underneath your left arm, twist, hold. One more time, unhook, switch out your ankles, left arm underneath your right arm, twist to your right, hold. Come through center, unhook, switch out your ankles, right arm underneath your left arm, hook, twist, hold. Good, come back through center, hold, and then just lower your right leg down. Your left foot should be on top, and we'll place it over our right knee. Drop your left butt cheek down, bring your left hand close with your base. Send your right arm up high toward the ceiling. And send your right arm, armpit, outside of your left thigh. Twist. Check that your left knee is facing up toward the ceiling here. Inhale, lengthen. Pull your navel in tight. And on your exhale, stay tall now. Twist so your belly button feels like it's going to pass your left thigh and face the back of the room. One more time. Inhale, lift up taller. And exhale, go twist. Go twist. Go twist. And gently untwist here. Return back into bow. So sit your butt back. Free out your legs. And see if you can just swap out your legs. Bend your left leg under. Put your foot over your left knee. Drop your right butt cheek down. All right, right hand close with your base. Lift your left arm all the way up high toward the ceiling. And then send your armpit outside of your right leg. Go twist. You have a couple of breaths here. It's easy to dump down. I totally do it all the time. So on your inhale, see if you can lift up. Use your right hand behind you to prop yourself up. Grow a couple of inches. Lift, lengthen. And on your exhale, twist a little bit deeper. One more time here. Inhale, lift up a little bit taller. Pull your navel in tight. And on your exhale, go twist. Belly button passes your right thigh best you can. Go twist. Go twist. Good. Gently untwist. You should be on the other side here as you just gently roll yourself over to your right. Sit your left foot underneath your left hip. All right. From this place, flex your right foot, lift up nice and tall, prop yourself up. And we just have these four leg lifts here. So flex your right foot, go four and lower and three. And really control that initial ascent and then that very last bit of the descent. Two and lower, last time, and go one. And then bend this right leg so your right toes are in line with your left knee and you're in this perfect place. Now, depending on your ankle flexibility, this will feel like no big deal or it'll feel like such a big deal. So definitely be patient with yourself. It's no problem. Hands to your heart. Let's stand. Go for four, three. There is a lot of pressure here in your left ankle too. Let's slowly lower down. Go for four. For three, tall as you can be. For two, and you just check here that your left toes are not sickling inward toward your center line. Up, go for four, so make sure toes are behind your left foot heel. And down you go for four, three, two. You have one and a half to go. So lift, go four, three, two. Down you go for four. Allow this left top of foot to feel something, yeah? Nice little stretch. One more time. Go four, three, two. And again, we're just gonna tick-tock, so I'm gonna scoot back a little bit. All right, from this place, hinge at your hips and come forward. Breathe. Point your left toes. Your left hip will wanna open up on you. Let's keep square for now. All right, keeping the same height of your leg, making sure you're not gonna hit anything. Send your left leg out to your left. Oh, I have a little obstruction. Out to your left, go out. And return. I might need to change my angle here. Oh, there we go. And three more times, go all the way out. And then your job is just to maintain this height best you can. And return. Two more times. Let's give it a whirl. Go out. And return. Last time. Chest and shoulders square. Left leg out to the left. Yup. And return. Stay with me here. As you upright your spine, start to flex your foot. So you're in single-legged Tadasana. Left knee up to hip height. Hold. Good. I'm going to face forward. From this place, just step your left foot in front of your right, like you're walking on a tight wire. Hold. All right, relax your arms down, close down your eyes, And just to breathe. Your weight will want to still be in your back foot, your right foot. Try to evenly distribute, shift slightly more into your front foot. On your inhale, arms go all the way up high toward the ceiling, lift. On your exhale, cactus backward bend, go lift your chest up nice and tall. Inhale, arms go all the way up. Keep your eyes closed and exhale. Cactus, lift your chest up. Inhale, arms go all the way up high. Fight for the balance. And lower your arms back down. Good. From this place, your back foot, your right foot. Ooh, I totally lost my balance. Send your right foot to the left of your left foot now. So you're sort of crisscrossed here. Arms go all the way up. Bend over to your left-hand side. So use the help, your left hand grabbing onto your right wrist to create more of a stretch down the right side of your body. One more breath in, lift up on your left-hand side. One more breath out, push your hips more toward the right-hand side, create some length. Good, gently come back up through center. And let's slowly lower down again. So your legs are still in this crisscross position, hands to heart as you bend. Let your heels just naturally lift up off of the floor. Sit, sit, sit. And once you're down there, control it now. Sit your butt back, lift, and your left ankle is on top of your right ankle. Hold. Good. We'll continue that cross. Instead of your ankles, cross your left thigh over your right thigh, and then maybe you give it that second cross. So one cross or two crosses, your choice. Inhale, lift your arms up. Exhale, twist over to your left-hand side, twist. Inhale, arms go all the way up. Do it again. Exhale, twist. Try to get your right armpit outside of your left thigh. Twice more. Inhale, lift. Exhale, right armpit outside of your thigh. Last time, inhale, lift, and exhale, armpit outside of your left thigh. Stay. I'm going to scoot up closer to you. All right, from this place, you're here, drop your feet down to the floor. So now that you have a little bit of stability, it should be easier to find more of a hook. So left hand down, feet on the floor, inhale, lift your right arm up, and then take your right armpit outside of your left thigh again, push. And then because I feel like I can do a little bit more, but I'm just not there yet, I'm just gonna take my left hand, push outside of my left thigh, and hook a little bit more from there. So hook, 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 push, 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 twist, twist, twist. And then I'm gonna unhook this bottom foot. So if you did that second hook, unhook it now. You only have that one hook. You have a good shelf of your right thigh. Take your hands close to you, about hip width apart, let's say, and then lift your butt up off of the floor. So shift your weight into your hands, lift your butt up off the floor, and return. Let's try that again. I've lost a lot of my shelf, so I'm gonna do that twist again. Second round, let's go. Hands on the floor, push, lift, and lower down. And then this last time, see if you can lift your legs up off of the floor as well. So I'm getting my hook, hands on the floor, lift your butt up off of the floor, bend your arms, look toward your legs, and pick your legs up off of the floor. You hold for four, for three, for two, and then gently release. Find yourself in the twist, hold, nice job. All right. From that place, let's gently switch. So release your arms, pick up your legs, and swap out your legs. Right leg on top of your left, one cross, maybe you try your second cross. All right, so from this place, take an inhale, lift your left arm up, and exhale, go twist over to your right. Second time, inhale, arms go up. Exhale, twist to your right, twist. So many obstructions. Two more times. Arms go up. And exhale, twist to your right. Last time, arms go up and twist to your right, hold. I'm gonna lower my hand down, my feet down. And then this hook, I currently only have my elbow. I'm gonna go a little bit deeper. Inhale, lift your left arm up. Get more of your left armpit outside, twist. And I already know that for me, this side, I'm getting less of a shelf. Like I already know my twist is slightly less twisty on this side. So I'm gonna give myself that manual assist. And in fact, I'm gonna unhook my second hook. So I only have the cross of my thighs. Push your right hand against your right thigh, hook more, twist. All right, let's try it then. Hands go to the floor. You wanna maintain this surface area of your left arm outside of your right leg. So for me, I like to keep my hands fairly close, not too wide, sort of like if you were going to do any sort of plank pose even, right? So hands, lift your butt, and you try. And lower back down. And we'll try again, so get more of that hook. Left arm outside. Lift your butt up off the floor, lift. And lower down. And your final time then, really hook it, hook, hook, hook. Hands down, lift your butt up, bend your arms, look past your left toes, and maybe you pick your left toes off of the floor. Hold for 4, 3, 2, gently release, nice. And then find yourself onto hands and knees. So hands and knees, we were here way back when. Let's find ourselves again with your left arm extended and your right leg just lifted up toward the ceiling bent. So extend your left arm, hold. And keep your right leg in place. Bring your left hand to your right shoulder, hold. Push your chest away. Pull your navel in tight. And again, lift your left foot, your bottom foot, up off of the floor. Hold right here. Breathe, go for 4. Pull your navel in tight for 3. We're gonna try to maintain this as we move for 2, for 1. So listen, nothing changes in all the parts except for your right leg. Hike your right knee out to the right. Try your left foot still off of the floor. Yes, and take your right knee back to its original position. Foot up toward the ceiling. And 2 more times. Right knee, draw it out to your right hand side. And take it back to its original position. It's a nice opening of your hips in conjunction with your core balance. One last time, knee out to the right. And lower your left hand down, keep your left foot up, send your right leg, kick it all the way out to the right, push your chest away, hold for 4, for 3, for 2, for 1. Bend it in, lower your left foot down, and send your left foot, or right foot, I'm sorry, up toward the ceiling, hold. Good. Kickstand your left foot out to the left. Your right leg is already bent, so just go ahead and grab on. Kick your right foot into your right hand, just like you did the first time. Open your chest. Kick your knee away from you, back behind. Hip forward, knee back. Kick over 4, 3, 2. And then keep holding onto your foot. Pick up your bottom foot. I'm gonna change my view so you can see. Pick your bottom foot up off of the floor. Hold for 4. Hold. For 3, hold for 2, hold for 1. Nice job, lower and shake it loose. Return to your hand and your knee. All right, perfect. We're on to the next side then. So your hands stay the same. Bend up your left leg so your foot sole faces the ceiling. And then from this place, just your right hand toward your left shoulder. Push your chest away. Hold right here, breathe. All right, just like we did earlier, send your right foot up off the floor, hold. And then, keeping your right foot off the floor, so you can send your left knee out to your left, and take it back. Return to the place, twice more only, try. Left knee out to your left, control it. And take it back. Last time, left knee out to your left. And return. Awesome work, not easy that one. Lower your right hand down. And then since your left foot is still up there, you can kickstand your right foot out, grab a hold, and then kick your foot away. See if you have a little bit more space relative to the beginning. I'm gonna just change the view here. Kick your heel away, open up through your chest. And then from here, your bottom foot, let's lift it off of the floor. See how this feels your second time around? Kick. Hold for four. Manage your balance. You got it. For three, kick, kick. For two, now I know I'm sweating definitely from this. And for one, gently return, let go, and lower your hand, your knee back to the floor. All right, from this place, let's find a plank. So send your toes back, move into your downward facing dog. Breathe. Pedal it out just a little bit. Wrap your upper arms in just a little bit. Breathe. Nice, slow. Through your nose. Exhale out through your nose. One more time here, in through your nose. Exhale out through your nose. So stay exactly in this position, right? All we'll do is take your left leg, flex your foot, and send your left leg out to your left leg. You're totally right, David. Send your left leg out to your left. Thank you, dear. And lower back down. Left leg out to your left. And lower down twice more. Left leg out to your left. And lower down, last time. Left leg out to your left. Circle it all the way up as high as possible. Hold. Breathe right here for four, three, two, and then lift up a little bit higher. Send your left leg all the way out to the side and return your foot back to the floor as if nothing happened at all. Breathe. So three tick-tock, circle, circle. All right, let's do the right hand side then. Leg out to the right, go right. And lower down. Twice more. Leg out to the right. And lower down. Leg out to the right. Keep your weight back into your legs best you can. And lower down. This last one. Take your right leg out to the right. Now circle it all the way up. And square off your hips. And then we'll do that again. So send your right leg up higher. And circle it all the way out towards your right hand side. Still your weight back into your left leg. And then lower it back down. Your foot flat against the floor. Breathe right here. Slow in. Slow out. One more time. Go in. And go out. Good. Lower yourself back onto your hands and your knees. David made a great point. Thank you, dear. Okay, so we were here. Let's bring our left leg up. Is that right? Yeah, left leg up. Send your left leg out to your left. This might not be even, David. I'm not gonna lie. I can't really remember. And then bring your left leg out to the left. Hold right here. Pick your right toes off of the floor. Breathe. And then try right hand to your left shoulder, maybe. And then return. Lower your right knee, right foot. Send your left leg back and bend it again. That may or may not have been right. I'm not gonna lie. Tuck your toes in back into the downward facing dog. Breathe. Okay. In your inhale, lift your left leg up, lower your left foot inside, hold. From here, shift right away into single-legged Tadasana. Right knee up, lift, hold, flex your foot. Just like we did on the floor, send your right leg out. And we'll lift from here. So think of this as your base, like your leg was on the floor, right? Three times. Let's go up, go three. Return to the base. Go two. Return to the base, last time. One, return to the base. Send it out to the right-hand side. Hold. You have three lifts. This is your base. Go up, go three. Lower it down. Twice more. Go lift and lower. Last time. Go one and lower. Return back through center. Good. Send it back. Low lunge. Take it all the way back. Hold. All right. Send your left leg all the way up high. Three-legged dog. Lift. And circle all the way around here. Left leg out to the left. And see if you can just touch left leg to your left tri. Send it all the way back up. I have some obstruction. Twice more. Left leg out to your left. Shift forward. Touch. And take it back. Last time. Shift and touch. And take it all the way back. Lower your left foot down. Downward facing dog. Breathe. Okay. Inhale. Lift your right leg up high toward the ceiling. Lift. Low lunge, step on in between. Step. Shift your body weight forward, single-legged Tadasana. Go lift, lift. Where your knee is, extend your left leg out. Hold, this is your base. Three times, go for three. Lower, two more, two. And lower, I'm struggle busting here. One, and take it all the way out toward your left-hand side. You got it, go for three, twice more. Go two, last time, go one, return back through center, and step back, low lunge. Step back, hold. And then send your right leg all the way back behind you. Lift. From this place, again, check your obstructions on your right-hand side. Keep your right leg straight and really circle it. Lift, lift, lift. Shift forward. Touch your right thigh to your right tri. Take it back up. Go lift. Twice more. Really lift it up. Shift. Right leg to your right tri, and take it back up. Go lift. Last time. Right leg to your right tri. Shift. And take it back up. Go lift. Lower your right foot down. Downward facing dog. Breathe. All right. Inhale. Left leg up high toward the ceiling. Lift. Step your left foot this time to the left of your left hand. Touch. Okay. Now that we're here, pick your left heel off of the floor. Lift, hold. Simply by lifting your left heel up, your left knee is higher up on your left shoulder. Pick your left foot up off of the floor. Push hard into your hands and find your left toes off of the floor. Hold right here. Push, go for four. Hold for three, for two. Again, left leg up high toward the ceiling. Lift. Return to that place we just were. Exhale, knee to your left. Go touch. Inhale, left leg up high toward the ceiling. Lift. Try this time. As you bring your left knee to your left, try shift forward. Shift your body weight forward. Maybe you pick your right toes off the floor. And inhale, left leg up high toward the ceiling. Try that one more time. Left knee to your left, try shift forward so much, you might pick your right leg up off of the floor and send your left leg up high. Again, your left foot to the left of your left hand. Touch, hold. Once you're here, lower your back knee down to the floor, open your chest. We did this earlier this week. Let's see what happens today. Pick your right foot up and lower it down. Three more times. Open your chest. Go lift and lower. Think about hitting your butt with your right heel. Go lift and lower. Last time. And go lift and go lower. Listen, from here, try, let's come down to our forearms. We've spent kind of some time doing this several weeks in a row, so maybe you can come down a little bit lower. Let's see how that feels. And if this still feels kind of okay, let's see if we can just take this left hand into like a C shape and push behind this left ankle just a little bit to wear our left leg like a backpack, right? So start to wear your left leg like a backpack and hang out right here. Even more with every breath that you take. Hold for four, for three, for two, for one. And then just staying right here. Let's see if we can try, if you're on your right hand, that's great. If you're right on your right elbow, that's great. So this will be asymmetrical if you're on your right forearm. If you're on your right hand, you'll be doing a normal symmetrical scissors. So I don't know that I think one is easier than the other. I think they're both kind of the same, but you can try with your right forearm on the floor. I'm gonna tuck my back toes in. And then slide, so my left knee is on top of the shelf. That is my left arm. Shift forward, pick your right toes up off the floor. I have some obstruction here. So I'm gonna shift back a little bit, but that's the idea. Once you're there, you shift, pick, and lift. And maybe you send your left leg out to the left as well. So maybe asymmetrical is a little bit harder. You're quite close to the floor. But if you're trying symmetrical then, same deal. Once you're in this place, your both hands are on the floor, give yourself some room in front of you. That's where I ran into something over here. I'm gonna give yourself some room because as you bend your arms, you shift quite a bit and extend from there. All right, so think of this as your shelf. We did that other shelf exercise earlier. So really create a strong shelf for your leg to sit on top of. All right, let's give that one more whirl. So again, you're here. You keep your left leg as high up on your thigh as possible. Once you're ready, you bend your arms, pick your left leg, shift and lift. Maybe extend your left leg. All right, how was that? Let's try the other side then. Send yourself back into the downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg up high toward the ceiling, lift. And then just start with your right foot to the right of your right hand, touch. And then once it's there, you pick up your right heel off of the floor, right? You pick your right heel up off of the floor. And once you're there, firm up your arms, push your chest away. And once you really get that nice strong grip, you pick your right foot up off of the floor. It's up on your right arm. Hold for four, three, two. Send your right leg up high toward the ceiling. Lift. And then we're gonna return to that same place. Exhale, shift forward, knee to your right, try, shift. All right, as high as possible each time. Inhale, right leg up high toward the ceiling. Lift, knee to your right, try, shift forward, maybe bend your arms, pick your back leg up off of the floor. And then return, send your right leg up high toward the ceiling. One more go, try. So your right knee to your right, try, shift forward, pick your back leg up off of the floor. Inhale, right leg up high. Right foot to the right of your right hand. Touch, hold. Okay. So let's lower this back knee down to the floor. And we'll do just those couple of heel to butt lifts.
So try. Up, go for four. Lower down. Up, go for three. Lower down. Again, you're on the soft part of your back knee. For two. Lower down. Last time. Go for one. And lower down. You're putting on your head when you... I am not putting my head on the floor. That's a great question. Let's come down to our forearms. That's a good question, Kathy. I'm very, very close to the ground though. So while you hang out here, I'll just show you real quick. All right, so you hang out here, really allow your left hip flexor to stretch and get open. Think of getting your left thigh closer and closer to the floor. And then, think of as you evenly distribute your weight over your both arms that this right leg really hugs in close and gets up as high as possible. So yeah, my face is very, very close to the floor though. So let me find an angle that looks kind of correct. Okay, actually I'll do it head on. Maybe that'll work a little bit better. So you stay there. Once you shift forward, you're here and you're super close to the floor. But this would be touching the floor, right? So I'm just up off of the floor, like an inch, maybe half an inch. And think of this as not, with all of these balancing exercises, think of this not as like a jump and hope, but a shift, a really dramatic shift of your weight. Maybe from this angle we can see. So I'm going here, I'm shifting, and then I lift. So it's kind of, this shift is quite dramatic, but it's not, a throw, right? It's sort of a shift and a weightlessness of your legs that allows you to lift up. So the hard thing is that it's hard to sort of feel that weightlessness, but the benefit of that, once you do find that weightlessness, you know for sure that you're not coming out of it, right? So it's sort of like a catch 22, like, yeah, it's harder to initially find that weightlessness, but once you find it, you kind of know that you will not lose it. So, okay, cool. So afterwards, what are we doing? Exactly, that's great, Ellen. An inch, like you're so like just sniffing your carpet. That's a terrible thing to say. You're sniffing your floor, right? You're very, very close to the floor or your hardwood or whatever it is. Okay, so let's give this a couple of tries then. You can try, so if you tried asymmetrical on the first side, I want you to try asymmetrical on this side as well. It's not really, and you'll be super close to the floor with asymmetrical, but definitely give it a try. So your left forearm will be on the floor and your right hand will be propped, right? So you have a little bit more space. Once you're there, you shift. This is my asymmetrical. All right, shift, shift, shift. And asymmetrical puts you real, real close to the floor, and it's less likely the case that you pop your back leg up a lot. With the symmetrical, you have a little bit more leverage and you're even obviously on the sides. And so as you dip, you can afford to send your legs up a little bit high or your back leg up a little bit higher. So let's give that one more whirl. So you're here, you shift. And you send your back leg up, up, up. And if you can, maybe extend your front leg as well. So you're really splitting out your 2 feet and then sending it back behind you. So give that one more try. The thing I like about the symmetrical is that you sort of have this teeter-totter situation. Once you let your upper body go down, it's not touching, but it's like super close. Like a seesaw, your leg on the backside should come up. So one more time. All right, so your hand's not too wide. I just noticed my hands were super wide. Not too wide. And then once you're down, you pick it up and you lift, lift, lift. And you take it back. So again, like the really nice thing is that once you feel that weightlessness, it should not be difficult to sustain the balancing posture, which is nice. So once we're finished with all of that, keep working if you're still working, which is so great. Find yourself in Malasana and we'll just do a quick shake of these wrists. And it's almost time to bust out your dancing shoes. So get your cameras ready. And remember, this is all about a little bit of posing. We are so switching gears right now. A lot of it's just attitude. Gotta just throw it out there and live. Let yourself live. You can take the, kind of using my left arm as a shelf. Oh, I totally hear you. I totally hear you. So you feel like your elbows are like digging into your rib cage type of thing. I think in the beginning there will be that sort of that it feels like it's a slight crutch, but I guarantee you if you just little bit, think about shifting it out a little bit. So your arm is hugged in, but it's not underneath you. I think you won't have difficulty, Ellen, in just doing that small shift of your arm. Give it a whirl, actually. I'm going to try to. And I think like for me, one side is a little bit easier to do. I'll do this side so you can see my, I was splitting toward you. I'll split away from you. You can see my bent arm, my free bent arm, I should say. So once I'm here, I'm just hugging in real close, but I'm not actually underneath me. All right. So I'm like sort of out, but just on this side of me. Now let's see. I feel like this one, I lean a little bit more. So that's a good test. So once you shift, actually, Ellen, I don't think you'll have an issue at all, actually. Now that I've tried it, I don't think you'll have an issue. Because I do totally understand what you're saying, kind of doing the dig in. And I know when I'm doing that, but right now I like very like consciously like made a decision like, okay, I'm like definitely not going to dig in, and it didn't feel like much different type of thing. So, wrists, press them towards each other. And once you press the backs of your hands towards each other, think of dropping your elbows down. So you have a nice little stretch going through the tops of your hands. And then maybe just do this kind of like rock forward and back type of thing. But I think you make a great point, Ellen, in that like if you don't like really make it a deliberate choice not to dig your elbow in, you'll default probably dig a little bit because it does feel a little bit easier. yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome. That's really good. And I think like really if we think about the TikTok teeter-totter effect, it ought to feel pretty good too. Like allow yourself to dip low. And I think once also, you know, Kathy had mentioned the whole like, is your face touching the floor type thing. Initially, when you approach any of these balancing postures, it does feel like very uncomfortable, right? Your face is so close to the floor and it like feels like, well, this is my moneymaker. I got to, you know, preserve it. I totally hear you. But I think like after you do several, and if you really don't feel comfortable, always just have like a pillow underneath you. And then, so if you feel like you are dipping in that, toward the floor, you at least have some mental sort of insurance for yourself. And maybe sometimes you do just completely fall down to the floor. A transition that I was working on for a while was crow to headstand. And that transition, it's just like, it feels like a big just like flop. Like just going from that place to carefully controlling it down. So I totally sort of understand that. But these hopefully, as they're not like transitions, they're just one straight up poses, they ought to feel maybe not quite so bad because it's a shifting as opposed to a like a tilting and a dropping situation. So hopefully that is comforting. But again, always like if you have like something that you want to put underneath your face too, that's always nice. What are we thinking? Do we want to do that dance one more time or is that super weird? Because we have like a minute remaining and we could totally play the dance thing one more time. Good, Kristen. I love it. But I think the great thing about actually falling rather than backing out before you fall is that once you've experienced it, you kind of know what to expect, right? So you know like sort of how bad the fall is, you know? And generally speaking, it's not terrible. It feels uncomfortable, absolutely, but it's not terrible. I'm down, Kathy. That's great, Molly. Yeah, let's do it. But I think we're gonna need to switch the videos. So I'm gonna switch the video and then we're gonna get ourselves dancing. We'll see how many people actually enjoy the dancing part by how many people join
this second video. Okay, I will see you in just a little bit.